Well, the four men that worked here, some of them were very strict, stricter than others, and they were very strict. They would have done a bit of slave driving, if you want to call it that. Well, there was someone called the Big Stick. He would have drove them on. There was another man, they nicknamed him the Shirt. He was never off your back. This here's one of their time boards here that you called in the morning when you came into work, and the timekeeper gave you these boards out. That board number was given out, he marked it in the book that you were in at 8 o'clock. That was their board for life, or until they shifted from one department, one yard to the other. The first two numbers, 35, was on this one. It didn't mean to say there was 35,000 men working in the place. That was just a number for the Victoria Yard, the Abercorn Yard, or the East Yard, and that was to let them know. And then you threw that in at 5:30 and you worked at 5:30 at night, and then he chucked you out. But some of the boys would have slipped home early and they'd give this board to their mate for him to throw two boards in, and then the other lad would have went up the town or anything at 2:30, 3:30. Well, if any of the boys were caught on at this, any of the boys that were throwing the boards in, they would have got suspended for 2 or 3 days. The toilet requisites, you got 7 minutes, you were allowed 7 minutes to go to the toilet, and you had to call your number in when you went in, the man in the office of the toilet, and he clocked you in on a book at 8:30, 9:30 or 10:00, whatever time, and then he came around with 7 minutes and gave the doors a wrap or a shirt, your time's up, you have to get out. Well, the workmen down here, they should be very proud of what Harnow has done for them. And they turned out many great ships. It wasn't just one boat, Titanic. They worked here and marvellous boats went out of here.